They had the moves, they had the sound, they had the hair. Milli Vanilli ruled the late 80s. Fab Morvan and Rob Pilatus skyrocketed from obscurity to international stardom, their debut album selling 7 million copies and winning them a swag of awards. But it was all a lie. Milli Vanilli didn't sing a single note. They were lip-syncing.
I think it's fair we show everybody where is the real singer.
Now, more than three decades later, a new documentary tells their side of pop's biggest scandal.
Fab, welcome to the show. It's been 35 years since you and Rob were exposed as lip syncers. Millions of fans were outraged. You had to hand back your Grammy. Do you think the world's forgiven you yet?
Of course, they did. They did. And as a matter of fact, I took it all personally at the beginning because I thought, oh, people hate us. But when I look back and year after year, I realized that the media and when a scandal occurs, it gets people to watch TV. People read more newspapers. So it's a business.
So are you a victim or a villain in all of this?
Well, you know, when you look at what happened during the press conference, that ugly press conference, it seems like the journalists forget about their oath, which is to be impartial, to investigate every character in a story. But that was not done. When I look at them, it's embarrassing to think that you call yourself a journalist. You were going after Rob and Fab instead of like, you know, what happened to the label?
You have to understand, we were seduced, we were abused, and we felt very guilty. But we are here. Robert Fab is here because we stopped it.
I was so young, yeah, no experience, even rhetorically with the language, I couldn't really respond. Rob had the power, and because he thought so hard, and also at the beginning embraced the lie, because we both embraced the lie for a long time. Eventually repeating, yes, we sang on the record, then he started to believe the lie. And because of the drug addiction that was taking place in his life, he was losing himself.
You were just 21 and Rob was 24 when you were spotted by music producer Frank Farian. Would you say you were tricked into signing a contract?
Well, we were not tricked to sign a contract. When he brought the contract, it looked like a recording contract. But mind you, I didn't know what a recording contract looked like because I had never signed one. So I signed it without a manager, without an attorney, and just signed it. And we got each 1,500 Deutschmark, thinking we're just doing one song. But in fact, we signed for three albums. So when it came time for us not to sing, we said, we're not doing this. Oh. You're not doing this well. Money is not free. Oh, money is not free. So you got to pay it back. How do you pay it back? You got to work, buddy. We did the first single. And then when you get that love that we never got in our home, and when that love came from the fans, it was like, oh man, that's nice. That feels great. So we were seduced by this lifestyle and by being loved. Obviously, it was a lie. But in the end, the weight of the slide got so heavy that we lost ourselves and had to medicate ourselves in order to numb our emotions, to deal with this crazy journey with no support system. We were tired of being used and abused.
Fab says they made a deal with the devil. The singing was done by John Davis, Charles Shaw, Brad Howell, and two white backup singers. And before they were found out, there were several close calls, with Rob having to flee the stage.
The label got nervous. We got nervous. We're like, oh my God, that can't happen. So that made us really nervous. And as a matter of fact, we kind of closed ourselves in. But obviously, you know, it was a golden cage. It was beautiful. It was like, but it was a cage still.
The public humiliation was brutal. Rob didn't survive the scrutiny. He died from a drug overdose in 1998. Fab, however, found solace and his own voice in music.
Blame it on the rain. Yeah, yeah. Music music became my therapy. So through music, I was able to heal myself. Music was like my friend, my mother, my father, my confidant. And I kept music really close.
You say in many ways yours is a story of hope. How so?
It's a story of hope and it's a love story at the same time. The story of hope because I believe that with this story, I'm able to show people that look at what happened to me. The planet was the playground and those two kids were being bullied. One of them died as a result of the bullying. He died of a broken heart. The other one managed to go through because of his passion, because he believed that he had to live his dream, because he loved what he did. And music is something that I love. So I hope that music brought me around the world. Oftentimes, I'll come your way, I'm sure. I'm sure of that.
Fab, thanks so much for chatting and congrats on the doco.
Thank you for listening.